So guys, today's video is an update 6 months about for our wind turbine that we installed.
Yep, lots of you have been asking how it's working and what we think of it. And it's been about half a year now, so we're giving you our honest thoughts today.
And we're gonna tell you the good, the bad, and the ugly. All right, so if you're new here and didn't see our install video of this 400 watt wind turbine from EcoWorthy, go back and watch that video first. We'll put a link in the top corner of the video.
Check it out.
Which corner? The one above my head or above your head?
Top right corner, I think.
Okay, I'll try my best. Yeah, it's going to be above Jenny's head.
Top right corner.
Ding!
So, that video showed you the unboxing and the install of this wind turbine you see above us. All right. We didn't get sponsored by that video, but EcoWorthy sent us that and wanted us to try it out. And we thought, what the heck? A lot of you were interested in it, so let's try it out.
Because it is very windy here.
Yep.
All the time.
Yep. And we've been running on solar for the last 3 to 4 years. And although it treats us very well for 9 to 10 months out of the year, there are a few months in the winter time where we don't see the sunshine. And our original intent to use this wind turbine was to help supplement that system. Well, that didn't work out quite as we had hoped. My hope was a 400 watt wind turbine would at minimum push about 200 watts. Let's just say 50% while it was moving, right? Well, unfortunately, I don't want to bust any bubbles or hurt anybody's feelings or disappoint anybody, but we didn't ever see anything over 50 watts out of this 400 watt turbine. So
maybe that's because we're in the woods and have lots of trees around us, and we're not like in the desert or on the prairie or on the ocean.
Yep. Those places I think would be ideal for a wind turbine of any sort, even these inexpensive ones, right? This is a $300 wind turbine setup. So this wind turbine is a hobby style wind turbine, which is what I would call it, because it's not a 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 watt turbine. There's not a huge investment in a system like this, but again, we originally set it up, one, just to experiment and have fun, and two, we were hoping, because our off-grid cabin only draws a couple hundred watts all day and night, that we could supplement our larger system with it when we were lacking sunshine.
Well, we didn't find it possible to do that.
Yep. Not only is this a 24-volt wind turbine, and we have a 48-volt system now, but that 24-volt wind turbine was only pushing, like I said, when we have a good 10 to 15 mile per hour wind, we got the max out of it about 50 watts.
So a lot of you have said in our previous videos to raise it or move it, and we can't really move it anywhere. Yeah. This is the best spot for it.
Next to the solar and next to our batteries. If we put it anywhere else on the property, we'd have to run line hundreds and hundreds of feet, mm-hmm. which would, again, be inefficient and not very feasible.
Yep, and we can't really raise it because we don't have a way to get any higher than it currently is.
Yeah, any way that you would put a turbine like this up high would cost a lot of money. You could maybe pick up a windmill tower or an antenna tower of some sort and install it. But honestly, when you get that involved into a system like that, it's going to cost you money. It's going to be dangerous. It's going to be involved. And we weren't willing to do that because solar works pretty good for us. And we didn't see the benefits of it. So we have been using it for 6 months. But we haven't been using it the way we expected. We were hoping, again, to supplement our larger system to keep the cabin going, but what did we do instead?
We are using it for our water pump, which is a 12-volt system, so it works perfect with this system.
Yep. This runs to a single 12-volt battery. The charge controller can charge a 12-volt battery or a 24-volt battery. It converts the power coming from the turbine into 12-volt or 24-volt. You could just set the parameters to do that. And that 12-volt battery that it's charging, we've been using it for our water pump. Now, our cabin is set up just like an RV. It uses a 12-volt, sure-flow, pressure-regulated pump. We don't have a big well pump like you see in a lot of off-grid or remote properties. We do rain collection and transfer water to a holding tank, and we simply use a small SureFlow 12-volt RV pump. It works great for our application.
And in those 6 months, we've not had any problems with the pump not having any juice. Yep.
And since it does well for that application for us, I think that is where this wind turbine could shine. This wind turbine would be good for a camper or someone who's maybe not full timing it in a normal cabin that is run with AC like we are, with AC appliances. I think it would work great for DC appliances, lights, things like that, small pumps like we're doing.
And a lot of you are maybe a weekend off-gridder or just part-time in it, working on your cabin, and this would work great for you for that time being. If you didn't want to invest into a big solar system, this could get you by for a couple days.
Yep. And then while you were away, it would recharge and your battery would be full upon your return in a week or 2 weeks or a month later. Mm-hmm. But because our system is a higher voltage system and the inverter's running all the time, the inverter would pretty much deplete a 12-volt system in itself. But if you're running on DC devices where you don't need a full-time inverter or inverter charger all-in-one system like we have, then you could run your lights and your small appliances and pumps without a problem.
We also saw a couple of these on boats when we were in Florida, and that'd be a really good use for somebody that's a boater that lives on a boat, because you're going to get energy supplied for you basically all the time.
So if you're out west in the open, in the prairies, or in high up like we are, but maybe even higher on a mountainside, lack of forest, we have a lot of tree blockage around here. All the wind from the north and northeast doesn't hit it. That's what's behind us. Now, when the wind is coming from the south and southwest, we get a good amount of wind that pushes this turbine around. Right now, the wind's just barely blowing, and it's coming from the northwest. So the trees are blocking it.
And it's not moving at all.
Not moving at all. So, and that's another problem we ran into up here in northern Michigan. In the winter time, most of our wind comes from the northwest, which is something I didn't put into consideration, because all summer long, the wind comes from the southwest and from the south, blowing the warm air up here. And then in the winter time, it primarily comes from the northwest and north. And then, again, we're blocked by the trees behind us. So as a note, maybe we did a poor job of installing this. It's been up. It's been working. Mm-hmm. It does work well when the wind's blowing from the right direction. So we think it has a good purpose in the right situation, right?
Yeah. If you didn't have stuff blocking it like we do and you lived again in the desert or the prairie, or you could put it up higher,
yep,
you're going to have no problem. You could get wind all the time.
Yep. Again, we've had this thing cooking pretty good with a good 30 to 50 mile per hour wind, and we've never seen over 50 watts out of it, though.
We do love our EcoWorthy products, though.
We used to have a solar tracker from EcoWorthy. We used that for about a year and a half until we upgraded our large array, and we are actually going to do a reinstall and a new install of one of those systems over by our new mini cabin.
Very soon.
Yes, and we're excited for that. A lot of you guys were concerned why we took it down, if it failed or if it wasn't working well. No, we love it. It worked very well. It was really fun to watch it track the sun and get very efficient numbers all day long.
Yeah, the sun wouldn't be on the main array panels anymore, but it would be catching the other ones, and he was still getting power production at like 8. Yeah. In the summer. He really liked to see that because it was working real well and it got us optimal power all day.
Yep. Yep. So when our stationary array wasn't doing good, that still was. So did we build a tower for our wind turbine?
No.
What did we do?
We took an old pine tree that we had cut down.
We cut that off at about 12, 15 feet, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then we welded the brackets to a well pipe, and that turbine is probably sitting at about 18 feet. Again, lots of tree cover from this side, from the north and northeast. We do get lots of wind from this direction, I promise you. So the 400-watt wind turbine from EcoWorthy then has the wires that come down here to our solar shed. I'll show you the system real quick. All this stuff here, we have videos on our solar setup. If you guys are interested in solar, we installed this stuff at different stages. We used to have an old AGM system with AGM batteries, 12 volters, and we've recently upgraded in the last year. We started with the Ruxu batteries, went to the Vaderers as well. So now we have a nice big system here. But our wind turbine comes down from above, goes to our charge controller. It has an unloader for if we have an overvoltage problem, which we have never seen. But then it takes power through the charge controller and down to this one old AGM. This is the, we used to have 8 of these. This 12 volt battery is treating us really good. It has wires that feed down into the ground and over to our cabin. And that feeds our only 12 volt device in our cabin. This is our switch to turn the water on and off for if we go away, so we don't have to worry about it running. Our battery is currently at 12.1 volts, so it's pretty low. We actually have not seen that wind turbine move much in the last week, right? So that battery will last us about a week or so for our 12-volt pump, because our 12-volt pump isn't running very often, only when we're showering or using the faucet itself. It doesn't run 24/7. I believe that SureFlow pump is probably around 100 watts. But again, it's only running for short bursts when we're using the faucet or the shower, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we don't have a lot of power consumption. We think that the wind turbine would be a good setup for someone, like Jen said, that's part-timing it, just a weekend warrior, or someone who is using only DC devices in an RV or boat. I think another shortcoming to this would be that when the wind isn't a steady wind from one direction. Something I've noticed that the wind turbine does is it does move well, but when the wind isn't a steady wind from one direction, like if the wind's swirling, the wind turbine will not adjust quick enough and will not keep its momentum. So I think if we were to experiment or try a different wind turbine, we would probably go with something that's like a vertical turbine, one of the ones that spins in a circle vertically rather than a fan type system like this. Because the wind, when it doesn't come from the same direction or it swirls, we don't get really good production out of it. So again, a lot of this is partially user error or user install error. If you were to put it up 100 feet in the air, I'm sure it would work way better. But that's,
we can't get 100 feet in the air.
That's not really realistic. I mean, I've had 100 people in our install video say, put it up higher, put it up higher. Well,
that's about as high as we could get it. I mean, without big machines, and then you're paying a lot of money to rent it or have someone come bring it here. So
build it. Or you're going to have string lines everywhere. I mean, you're just going to have anchor lines and cables and or huge expensive towers. I mean, solar.
And that's only
solar.
That's only if you're somewhere in the woods where you need it to be higher. If you're flat lands and open lands, then you don't need it to be high up in the air.
Yeah, you could get away with 20 feet like this one is. We've seen some people on YouTube have success in that way and doing it that way, right?
Mm-hmm.
So although the wind turbine didn't produce and act the way we were hoping it would, and we were able to use it the way that we wanted to, it does produce power. And it would work good in certain applications. So don't write it off completely. Again, partially user error or user install.
If you have any more questions, something we didn't answer, or you'd like to see us maybe test out even, drop them all in the comments below. We like to see what you guys think or see what other ideas you guys have.
We want to be helpful if we can.
Yep.
So thanks for watching this video, everybody. And we hope it was helpful.
Yep. And if you're new here, be sure to hit that subscribe button. We're trying to hit 100,000 subscribers this year. So we can't do it without you. So hit that subscribe button and follow us along.
And we hope to see you guys in the next video. Best wishes.
Bye.